Hey, John Christani here, and I'm going to go over in this video how to make $1,000 a day on the internet. Now, I'm going to be going over three different tips to helping you make $1,000 a day on the internet. And if you're wondering who I am and how I'm allowed to speak about this, I currently run an online business that makes me over $10,000 a day online. And I also have some offline businesses that make me thousands of dollars more. Now, I encourage you to take out a pen and a piece of paper to really retain this information. You'll want to be taking notes. Strap in and let's get it. Now, the first important thing to know about making $1,000 a day on the internet is you need to find a market and multiple things to sell to that market. Most people think about just the product they want to sell, but not the marketplace. If you really learn about a marketplace, it's easy to figure out what to sell them. There are also going to be multiple things in any marketplace that people want to buy, not just one. If you sell multiple things to the same audience, it's much easier to hit that $1,000 a day mark. You don't need as many people to reach if you just focus on selling lots of products to a smaller market. For example, you could be like many of the hundreds and hundreds of other people who sell my course on the internet and earn a $500 commission. But people who purchase my online training course, which teaches affiliate marketing, those folks also need and desire many other things, which you can sell to that same audience and earn commissions from. Let's look at other things people need. Website Builder, ClickFunnels offers great commissions, $50 a month. Click Trackers, like Volume or Click Magic, also offers great commission structures for people to sell them. Advertise, there are a number of advertising networks you can be affiliates for. Affiliates for affiliate networks and earn commission whenever people join an affiliate network. And there are many more tools out there that help people do marketing that you could sell and go deep and turn that one $500 commission into a laundry list of commissions that adds up to multiple times what you originally would have made. Now, if they're buying everything through you, hitting this income level gets a lot easier because you've gone deep and you're getting much more money from a much smaller audience. You don't need as many customers to reach your goal. Now, the second piece of advice I have for getting to $1,000 a day on the internet is get the market on multiple lists of yours. Most people try to make the sale without getting folks on any list of theirs. Now, start with getting people perhaps on your email list and give people value if they're going to give you their email address. Maybe give them a free ebook, maybe give them a free download, something that offers value. But don't stop there. Most marketers stop there and that limits their earning potential. After you get somebody on your email list, maybe get them inside of a group on Facebook, Skype, Discord, and build a stronger community. On my Facebook group, for instance, we offer a ton of resources and information, and we also offer the benefit of community for people to be able to see recent announcements and live streams. Discord, once again, community with a ton of information and the ability to directly message and connect with other aspiring marketers to help you out. Once you start building communities, you can get them on messenger lists, bot lists, push notifications, SMS lists, and you'll be able to reach people in more places where they might be active. Now, folks in your market are seeing your message in multiple places, not just one place. And this means they'll buy from you sooner rather than later because you don't need to rely by hitting them on just one platform. And the third piece of advice I have for making $1,000 a day online is just provide a lot of value. Provide genuine value to folks and also make pitches to them constantly. It's about the combo of providing value that adds something to your followers' lives and also pitching consistently, because you gotta sell stuff. Now, if all my YouTube videos were just straight product pitches, saying, hey, buy my training course, guys, buy my training course. It's the best, right? You wouldn't watch me because that would get boring and old very fast. But on the flip side, if I never told you about my course, or if I never told you about how you could be an affiliate for my product, nobody would ever buy from me, or at least not on YouTube. So it's about this balance. And most marketers are really bad at this balance of value and pitching. I like to say 80-20, offer 80% value, 20% pitching. If you're constantly pitching, then people are never going to follow you. If you're constantly adding value but never pitching, you're not going to make a lot of money. You're not going to be able to provide as much value as you'd like because you can't afford to. Now, learn the balance and you'll be in a good place. And this just takes time, and every audience and every market is different. A simple way to do that is just provide a lot of value and then pitch something at the end. This video, for instance, teaches about affiliate marketing. And then I'll maybe let you know I have a course at the end. Ask you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Now, one thing to understand about my course is that if you have more money than time and you want something step by step, check out my training course on affiliate marketing. Whereas if you have much more time and you don't have any money, then just look through my 500 or 600 YouTube videos. Again, it'll take much longer, but they're free. Apply the same logic to your marketing approach and you'll do just fine. Thanks for watching. And as always, make sure you subscribe if you like this video. Second off is if you want to indulge in the community and talk to other people, because I'm, you know, in my free time, I'm hanging out with my family, right? Is join the Discord channel, because in Discord, you'll be able to chat with others. You'll be able to see what other questions folks ask, etc. And as always, check through my other videos, go through my archive. It's all fairly unorganized in there, but I've talked about almost every question that people have wondered about on this channel. And there's a lot of great content in there. So thanks for watching. Talk to you soon. See ya.